What's up, you guys? It's Graham here. So let's talk about the current state of cryptocurrency, what's it caused, and whether or not this could potentially continue dropping further. Now, I'm already aware this might be a bit of a controversial video. Some of you guys might actually really like it and agree with it. Others might disagree with it, they might get their feelings hurt, they might get upset, they might start crying, and they might start rioting in the streets. But all I ask is that if you disagree with me, instead of just hitting the unsubscribe button, the dislike button, and then calling me nasty names in the comment section, at least just put together a well-formed argument of why you disagree, and I'm totally open to hearing your insights and any perspectives you might have. Just put a little bit more effort into it besides go Graham exclamation point times 1,000. Consider this video a little bit more like a two-way discussion where I'm going to be presenting my thoughts and opinions to you guys, but you're free to counter any of my arguments and perspectives below, and I'm going to read absolutely everything. And as always, I'm primarily a real estate and investing focused channel, and I intend to keep it that way, but I feel like a lot of this ties into investing in general, investor psychology, and wealth building. So even though I'm going to make the occasional crypto video every now and then, mainly because I find it really interesting and I'm also invested in it, I'm not gonna make too many of these videos unless there's something actually worth talking about, which there is today. So let's get right into it. It's no surprise that the cryptocurrency market has fallen from an $830 billion market cap to just about $420 billion right now. That's over a 50% decline in just the last month alone. So what caused this and what can we expect moving forward? Is it a smart time to buy in right now, or is it a disastrous idea to try to catch a falling knife if it's going to continue dropping even lower? Now, to answer those questions, it relies on us looking at both investor psychology and also at the recent events that have taken place that could have implications moving forward. Now, first off, I'm not going to talk about any of these weird conspiracy theories that suggest that the government is manipulating cryptocurrency prices to steal all of our money. Come on, let's just get real here. While I certainly believe that there's some Wall Street manipulation going on and they're taking an opportunistic stance on recent events, I think it's a lot bigger than just that, and there's a lot of other factors to consider. So first, let's talk about one of the very subtle points that I believe almost all of us can relate to, and that is investors are getting impatient and the growth that we saw was largely unsustainable. So let me explain. People are getting frustrated that the price of crypto hasn't gone up in like a month. And as much as we need it, the worst thing for cryptocurrency from this standpoint is stability. Stability is boring, stability isn't exciting, stability isn't sexy, stability doesn't get people talking about it. If people aren't talking about something, it has a very difficult time attracting new money, and then people just get bored and move on. The excitement of getting like a 20 to 50% or higher return in a day just dwindles when the coin really hasn't done anything for a few weeks, or even worse, you end up losing money. Crazy, right? Investors don't make money if the price just holds stable. So what do many people do? They decide to cash out and then look for other opportunities with bigger returns. Many people largely got spoiled by the last few months of upward movement, but like I said, that type of growth was entirely unsustainable. It has to end at some point in favor of more stability in a normalized market. Now, while these impatient investors are often not the whales who drive the market, they are the ones who start the initial wave of popularity and hype, which then in turn attracts more money. And if these impatient investors get bored, there goes the initial spark of speculation. And what caused this, from my perspective, was the lack of real-world utility for the price it was formerly trading at. You can only attract new money for so long until the prices stop rising, people start cashing out, more people start cashing out, the market dips, more people get scared of that and cash out as well, and then all of a sudden everyone is panicking, everyone is trying to sell at the same time, then the market ends up overcorrecting, and then it's just a weird vicious cycle from there. At some point, this is a bit unavoidable, and it was just as likely to happen when Bitcoin hit 20,000 as it was at 30,000, at 15,000, at 18,000. Didn't really make any sort of difference there, but it had to happen somewhere. The second thing I want to mention that's also probably the most impactful is all of the legal uncertainty surrounding cryptocurrency at the moment. In a speculative market like this, any chance of regulation will send a lot of people into a state of panic. China banned ICOs last September, calling many of them fraudulent. Further rumors suggest that China could be cracking down on cryptocurrency in general and cryptocurrency miners. Then more recently, rumors began spreading around that India would be banning cryptocurrency, which was later proven false. Point being, regulation in these sub-markets, in theory, shouldn't impact the market as a whole from a utility standpoint. Cryptocurrency is worldwide, and one segment shouldn't have the immediate implication as it does right now. However, the significance this poses is all about fear. And it's the fear that if one area bans or regulates cryptocurrency, it sets the precedent that other areas are to follow. But in all seriousness, I do think there should be some regulations and laws that people have to abide by, even though this largely goes against cryptocurrency, which is to be entirely unregulated. Having an entirely unregulated market leads people to do some pretty weird things for money, which leads me to my next point.
Be connect!
Which, number three, I want to talk briefly about the failing of BitConnect and also the BitGrill exit scam. This by itself was not a cause of the recent price drop, but it's more so just a symptom of what is currently allowed and what we can expect to see more of in an unregulated market like this, which, like I said, is not sustainable.
That's a scam!
Now, for those of you who it's your first day on the internet and you haven't heard about BitConnect before, it was basically a pyramid scheme that promised pretty hefty returns and relied on the price of Bitcoin going up, and also new money being put into the system to continue paying these payouts. And after being served with cease and desist letters combined with the price of Bitcoin falling in price, they basically closed up shop and many investors lost a ton of money in this. Couple this with the exchange of BitGrill, whose owner pulled an exit scam pretty much because he could and ran off with millions of dollars. Now this gets me thinking, how much longer until the government decides to step in and regulate this to essentially protect us against ourselves? And also, will there be any legal repercussions for someone promoting a cryptocurrency pyramid scheme or a company like BitConnect who can anonymously run away with hundreds of millions of dollars?
What am I gonna do?
As of right now, it's widely unclear, but one thing is certain, in that we will find out and that this will set a major precedent moving forward. Now, Facebook understood the ridiculousness of this by banning cryptocurrency ads on their platform, which I largely agree with. Many of these ads were fraudulent, they contained false information, misleading headlines, and very scammy ICOs. And I hate to say it, but also the ease and effectiveness of marketing through Facebook and also YouTube made it way too easy to get interest and money from these platforms. Just like people promoting BitConnect with a referral link, at what level is someone held responsible? And at what point does something cross over from entertainment to illegal activity? And at what point should someone be responsible for influencing the decisions of other people? All of this falls into a very gray area that's yet to be discovered. Now, the fourth point I want to make is that with the push to regulate these markets comes the requirement for exchanges to verify its users' information in order to withdraw funds or move money around, especially in high dollar amounts. I do value being an entirely anonymous stranger on the internet, but at the same time, if you're moving tens of thousands or sometimes millions of dollars through these exchanges, you bet the government is going to want to know who is moving the money around in a way for these exchanges to identify you. Now, they could say that it's to prevent money laundering, illegal activities, and terrorism and all that stuff, but let's be real here. Realistically, it's so that they can make sure that you're paying taxes on it. And with this comes a requirement that many exchanges will need to verify their users' information or risk getting shut down. This ends up putting the exchanges in between a rock and a hard place in terms of operations. Now, again, this is not a cause of the recent price drop, but it is a symptom of the current state of the market and also the growing pains of legitimizing cryptocurrency. And frankly, from a certain perspective, this could actually be a good thing, and that cryptocurrency is finally being taken seriously. It's going to weed out a lot of the bad apples and a lot of the scams, and the good, legitimate coins are gonna have more room to grow. And my fifth and final point is that we're slowly starting to see the price of Bitcoin dwindle as we see Ethereum slowly take over from a practicality standpoint. And this isn't surprising to me at all. When I bought Bitcoin originally, when it was just about $17,000, I did some more research and then I ended up selling it shortly after for Ethereum just because I felt it had more potential, more practicality, seemed to scale a little bit better, and I felt it was more functional. And then the more I looked into it, the more I realized that other coins could actually have way more potential than the holy grail of Bitcoin. Theoretically, we shouldn't see a drop in market cap if money is moving from Bitcoin to Ethereum and other smaller coins, but it does put uncertainty within a cryptocurrency that most people know about and are familiar with. Bitcoin is still like the metric we measure everything else against. If a person's confidence in Bitcoin diminishes, the entire market seems to diminish as well. So with that said, here's what this means from my perspective. Even though prices have been depressed lately, I think this is a move in the right direction for cryptocurrency in the long term. Now, before you think I'm crazy, just hear me out on this. Moonlight growth is just unsustainable in the long term. You can't have coins going up in price 100 times within a few days, and people making millions of dollars overnight from this. You can't have people promoting pyramid schemes and profiting without legal repercussions whenever that fails. You can't have exchange owners just picking up and running away with tens of millions of dollars just because they feel like it. You can't have some random dude create his own ICO and then pay John McAfee to promote it on Twitter and then cash out at its peak, earning millions of dollars. And short-term investors in it just for a quick profit won't be able to consistently make money without losing money at some point. Now, in terms of whether or not it's a good time to buy right now or not, the truth is, no one knows and no one is psychic. But just like any investment, it's a really good idea to take a step back and see things for the long term, not the short term. Now, in terms of having a long-term outlook, I found it funny that when I made a video that I was not buying Bitcoin at 10,000, people were calling me a because it went to 20,000, and then I missed out on potentially doubling my money. Even though I doubled my money in real estate without all the volatility, and everything's gonna be tax-free when I do a cash-out refi anyway. Then when I made a video that I finally ended up buying in Bitcoin around 17,000, people were congratulating me by saying, oh my God, you were right, it went to 20K, well done. And then when it dropped below 17 about a week later, even though I had long sold by then, people were calling me an idiot for buying near its peak. Now, my point being is that none of us know what's going to happen in the short term, and it's short-sighted to point out short-term fluctuations as an indication of whether or not something was a good or bad investment. Realistically, what matters the most is where prices will be a year from now, not next week, not next month, unless you plan on short-term day trading Bitcoin, in which case I recommend that's basically just gambling. So, I mean, you could get lucky and maybe not, but besides that, it doesn't really matter what the price is going to be a few days from now or a week from now. And I might get some hate on this one, but even reading candlestick charts and technical analysis can only go so far with cryptocurrency. Now, while you can measure some key resistance and support levels from a psychological standpoint, a well-timed tweet or positive article will have way more of an impact on price than any sort of technical analysis. So pretty much all I'm trying to say is that if the market drops, don't panic. Now, while past performance doesn't really indicate future results, it does give us the perspective that we should just take a step back, and in any market, patience is key. And just for the lulls, I'm gonna make a stupid prediction about what I think is gonna happen, and we can look back at this in a few months or a year from now, not a week from now, and see if what I thought was gonna happen actually happened. Personally, I think we're entering a time where the prices of cryptocurrency are gonna be a little bit more stable and a little bit more unsexy, where we're not gonna be seeing these huge price swings that we were accustomed to for the last few months. Right now, from what I'm seeing, fear is largely running the market, and a lot of people are sitting on the sidelines just waiting for this to continue to drop, and they're not gonna buy in until they start to see a bit of an uptrend. Now, as a total guess on this one, I think we'll see a fluctuation of Bitcoin somewhere between $7,000 and $10,000 for the near future, while government figures out the regulations and tries to fine-tune a lot of the things that just are growing pains of cryptocurrency in general. At the same time, I think we're gonna see government regulation overall just easing up a bit worldwide, but I also think that we're gonna see a little bit more regulation in terms of what someone can and can't do in terms of scams, which frankly I think is a positive for cryptocurrency. What it really comes down to is just uncertainty is the biggest enemy when it comes to a cryptocurrency market. As long as there's any sort of uncertainty in the market, prices will continue to stay down. But once the regulations are really set in place and ironed out, we're gonna see a lot more money pouring into the market because the uncertainty was taken away, and at least investors know what they're getting into. We're also starting to see some smaller companies adopt and embrace altcoins that have a very useful functionality behind them. And by doing so, this is going to legitimize the market as a whole. I can definitely see Ethereum continuing to climb overall, and a lot of the other really coins out there just continuing to decline, eventually just ending altogether. I think we're gonna see a lot fewer ICOs and a lot fewer pyramid and Ponzi schemes as government cracks down on these. And then we may start to see some legal regulation and action taken against those that are in pump and dumps, shill groups, Ponzi schemes, or anything else of that nature where someone's profiting with insider trading. Now, we're probably gonna see some upward movement, but I think a lot of people are going to be scared and just cashing out to break even at those levels. So I think for the long term, a lot of those people have to sell off, build up new momentum from the very beginning in order to break past those levels. So we're likely gonna be in a point of stabilizing and consolidating for a little bit before we see the next breakout period. And I have no idea when that might be. And again, for the way I see it, this is inevitable and just an indication of a growing, healthy, brand new market and just what had to happen in order for it to continue growing bigger. But at the end of the day, who knows? I think it's better to do this with a long-term approach and a long-term outlook, and not so much as a get-rich-quick mentality and get-rich-quick idea for you to go and like buy something and then make $1 million overnight. So the entire takeaway of this is 2 points. Number one, have patience and a long-term outlook with something. And number two, I have absolutely no idea what I'm talking about, and all of this is just a guess. So don't take it with fact. This is just my perspective, just my opinion. I could be very well wrong. I have no idea, just a guess. Take this for what it's worth, for entertainment value only. And I have to say this just in case I'm actually wrong, but who knows? And the same thing goes with almost everyone else in the cryptocurrency space. We all have educated guesses, but they're just that. They're just guesses, so take them for what they're worth. Now, if you agree with me or disagree with me, let me know in the comments section down below. If you disagree with me, let me know specifically what points you disagree with or anything I've missed or haven't thought of. I would be interested in reading your responses and seeing what you have to say. And also, if you watch the whole thing and you haven't subscribed yet, make sure to smash that subscribe button and also add me on Snapchat or Instagram or both. Posts are pretty much daily, so if you want to be a part of it there, feel free to add me there. Thank you again for watching. This is probably a long video. Until next time.